Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. I welcome you on Sanjay Gupta Tech School. In this video, I am going to demonstrate you how you can automate your survey invitations. So for this thing, you need to do these three points. So first I will be creating a survey. Then I will be creating a process builder to send the survey invitation. And then we will explore the survey responses, right? So if you're going to implement these things in your org, so you need to follow these steps. So first I'm going to create the survey. So moving to my org from this. So before creating survey, you need to search survey in the setup and you need to enable the surveys. So this should be enabled so that survey object, or you can say tab, will be available for creating surveys. So now, here I am searching for the survey. So this tab is available. I am clicking on it. So here you can see recently viewed surveys are available. And if you want to create new survey, so I'm going to create it. So what is the scenario? Like we are going to create a case, and when case is closed, so we are going to send a survey to contact that is populated on that case, so that contact can submit survey related to the service provided by a company, right? So our first step is to create the survey. So this is the survey builder. Here you can provide the name of the survey. So case survey. Three options are available: build, send, and analyze. So we are not going to send the survey manually. After building this, we will be activating the survey and we will send this automatically. So here you can see two options are available: pages and branding. So in branding, you can set the background image. So this is the default image provided by Salesforce. You can upload your as well. Then background image opacity. So this you can set as per the requirement. Background image blur, color, content card, question, answer colors, their opacity, start, next, and finish button color, text color, previous button, button color, and text color. So each and everything you can customize as per the branding of your company. Then these three pages, you can create welcome page, then your survey question pages, and then thank you page. So first I'm going to create welcome page. So here I'm writing the message. Thank you for your, let me write something different. We appreciate your time to submit this survey. Making it bold italic. You can apply other formattings as well, because it is a rich text, and here you can describe your survey as well, right? So this is the welcome page that we have created. Then here you can see page one. So now there are two options. So for each and every question, you can create separate pages, or you can add all the questions together on same page. So I'm going to tell you both. So here you need to click to add the questions. I'm selecting this one, like and dislike. So did you like our company services, right? And these two buttons will be available there. Now, if you want to add more question on same page, so you can click on this button. And let's say I am going to pick rating. I think it is something related to this like, dislike. So if you want to remove this question, like you don't, you selected this one and now you think this is not fitting to your requirement, so you can delete this from here as well. And you can select something different. So here you can see it is for scale from 0 to 10. So you can increase or decrease your scales, like it is decreasing, and scale our service. Right, so this is our second question. Now I'm going to add one more page for new question, right? So this page number one will be having two questions. Did you like our company services and scale our service, right? And for this, I'm choosing one more like long text. Provide your valuable suggestions, right? So answer will be provided here in this box. So this way you can create one more page, and if you want to add more questions, so here various options are available, so you can explore them as per your requirement later. So now I am moving to next screen, that is thank you page. So here I'm writing thank you for submitting your response. So this way, all four pages are available. If you want to see a preview, so it will be available here. So this is welcome screen. You appreciate your time to submit the survey. Click on next. Then here you can see this is one page having two questions. This is first question, like, wait, next. This is second page having only one question. So here you can provide your valuable suggestions and then finish. So this way, this was the preview, right? And now one more thing, if you want to delete your page, copy and page branching logic. So you, if you want to apply some logic, like if this happened, then this page or this question should be displayed. So based on that, you can apply logic as well. So right now I'm not doing this. And one more thing, if you want to make this question required, so you can choose this option. So now a user has to select a particular option for this question, then only they can move forward. So this you can do as well. And if you don't want to have this description, so you can remove this. So description will be removed, right? So after this, I'm activating this. So we are creating case survey. So after activating this, so this will be created. So version one is created. Now, if you want to send this manually, so two options are available. You can get the link and you can send emails. Remember one thing, you can send these surveys to the user of the orgs and the community users. These two users can receive these surveys only. And after sending the survey, you can analyze like what is the response of your survey. So we will analyze the response of survey later on. So right now we completed our first step, that is to create survey. Now I'm going to create a process builder that will be sending this survey automatically. So moving to process builder, creating new. So I will be creating this process builder on case. So name of this process is case, record changes, clicking on save. So whenever case will be closed, this survey invitation should be sent. So here I'm going to select object as case. When a record is created or edited. Now I'm adding the logic. So check status. So we need to check the status of the case. So here I'm selecting a field as status. So if it is equals to closed and if status is changed, right? If both the conditions are true, then only a survey link will be sent. So I'm adding the action and here you will see send survey invitation action. So action name is survey. So from here I need to select a survey. So case survey I'm selecting, then email content. So here you can select two things. You can select a survey link or you can select questions. So I'm selecting survey link. Then email template. So embed a survey link, recipient type, user in the org. And here we need to select the recipient field. So Let me search this again. So here I am selecting contact owner ID, right? So on case, we will be having a contact populated and the owner of the contact will be receiving the survey, right? So we cannot choose email field here because we need to choose the users. So who will be the owner of the contact will be receiving this email. So this I am choosing for demo purpose. So as per your requirement, you can choose another user as well. So it depends like for which object you are using this survey. So maybe if you're using this survey for opportunity, so opportunity owner you can choose, or maybe if you want to send this survey to case owner, then you can choose case owner as well. But I want to send this survey to contact owner. So I'm choosing that. And here four options are available: unique link, anonymize responses, do not require authentication, and invitation expires in days. So these four options you can also use. So right now I'm not using them. So I'm clicking on save. So this way, this automation is ready. Now I'm going to activate this. So here you can see I have created one case already, and here case contact is this user. So I'm opening this contact and the owner of this contact will be receiving the email. So if we go to details, so the owner is Sanjay. So this is the user with which I am logged in. So if I open this, so the email which is populated for this user will be receiving the email, right? So here you can see the details. So this is the email ID which will be receiving the survey link. So I have already opened my mailbox. So now I'm going to close this case. So case is closed. Now moving to my email box. Here you can see this mail is available. So it is showing my name, organization details, and this is the link to open and fill the survey. So I'm opening this, clicking on next. So here you can see this is required. So right now I'm not choosing like or dislike, I'm choosing this option only and clicking on next. So you can see one or more question require an answer to continue. So you need to choose this or this, then you can only click on next. So here I'm typing as test and clicking on finish. So this is the finish screen. So this way response is submitted. Now I am moving to this survey. Yeah. So here we can complete our third step. So first and second step I have completed, and I hope you understood how we can send survey automatically through Process Builder. Now we are going to explore the survey responses. So here you can see case survey record is available for the survey that we created. And here if you go to related list, so here survey version details will be available. So if you modify your survey and you create various versions, so all the versions will be available here. And this is the survey invitation that sent automatically. So I'm opening that. And if I go to related list, so here you can see the responses. So I have to open this, right? So here you can see I have opened the response, and in the related list, I can see the responses that is provided by the user. So scale our service, I gave 5, then valuable suggestion I provided test, and do you like our company service, I provided like. So this way you can explore the responses provided by the user for a particular survey, right? So these are different objects which are related with each other. So this way, I hope you understood how we can create survey, how we can send a survey to a particular user. So to whom you need to send the survey, that you need to identify so that you can choose that user. So in our case, I chose contact owner. So contact owner received the case survey. So maybe in your process, the user will be different, and then you can explore the survey. And later on, you can also create reports on survey responses. So I hope this way you enjoyed this video, like how to automate survey invitations. So this is very important in nowadays, because this is a new feature of Salesforce, and various organization uses this feature in their org so that we can send surveys automatically after completion of a process. So I hope you understood whatever I demonstrated. And if you want to watch more Salesforce training videos, you can go to the description of this video and you can find links of various playlists available there. Thank you for watching this video.